What is up, guys? Welcome back to another episode of Uber Cold Garage. On this week's episode, we are getting back into the bug. So, lots and lots of big things coming. Some good progress so far. So, hope you guys enjoy.
So, if you don't follow me on Instagram, you would miss out on the clip of this. A little sneak peek. So, this is the majority of the roll cage. I have these 2 8-foot pieces that'll be running pretty much the length of the car. I got the main hoop, the halo bar, the down bars, the rear bars, dash bars. These ones are kickers. I have a dash bar, a harness bar, and then I'm not actually 100% sure on what that one is. So they might have accidentally sent that one or something, I don't know. But I'm actually going to use these 2 runners and maybe 1, 2, 3 of these in the actual chassis. And then the rest will all go together like a normal cage. And then later on, I'll buy more bars to do the front section of the cage. And then the rear section of the cage. For those two, the front and rears, I'm going to have to buy a tubing bender. So I'll buy a roll cage bender. As soon as the Ghia is gone, I'll do that and order more tubing, so then I can finish off the chassis. Other than that, I have all the front suspension minus coilovers. The rear suspension I'm gonna change up quite a bit, so I might have to buy a couple more bits and pieces from that, but this is a huge start to the chassis, so the bug should be jamming along here pretty soon, and let's get to getting all these bits and pieces into the car. So, got a little bit ahead of myself and forgot to film, but here are the 2 full-length pieces. I went ahead and bent them so they are mirrored. Each one of these will go the length of the bug, well, of the chassis, the front part of the chassis. And then I've got everything on the actual frame braced up, so I got a space from there to there that's the same as the space from there to there. So got that where it needs to be, the width of the bug, everything like that. So I went ahead and cut a notch out right here. I cut the end plate off of this. That'll get re-welded back in. I also did the same on this side. I'm going to run that tube way out here. It'll go in, kick, and then kick back, follow the heater channels on both sides, so we'll get those in where they need to be, and then I can get measurements for the bars that run across for the seat rails, and then I have 2 that run up front, so we'll get those. I also have square tubing that runs along the back that'll finish off the front side of the chassis. That is on back order, so hopefully it comes within the next couple days. If not, it's not a huge deal. I can still get the cage and all that stuff done. And then I'll go ahead and fill a couple more holes, cut off the back, clean up the rest of the chassis, clean up the heater channels, fill these sections back in. Well, get them to where the body sits back into these sections correctly and strong. So I'll do that, and then I can paint the chassis and then get the cage all set up and everything like that. So maybe I'll save painting the chassis until the cage is fully welded. But then after that, I can paint the chassis, the cage, all that. So let's get those into that and keep rolling along. Got a few bars notched. Got this one up front, runs that length, and then both of the seat rails. So after this is all tacked together, the bracing will get cut out. But those seat bars go all the way through the tunnel and all the way across. Before they were just welded onto the actual tunnel, which I'm sure would have been fine, but I feel way safer with a full bar all the way across, and then the full runners that run all the way. So the main hoop will actually tie in here, go up and over and tie into there, rather than having floor plates. The Volkswagen Bug floors they're pretty thin sheet metal. So even with the 1/8-inch steel on there, I still didn't really feel safe with it. So now that I have to redesign the chassis, this is gonna be the new design. I actually made a model, so I'll show you that in the next clip. Kind of a general idea of what I want the cage to be. What I want it to look like. Another cool thing about having these runners is, as you can see, there's a lot here. It's actually too long. Looked a little crooked on camera there, but it's not. So my next bar will go across right here, and then I'll have one more out here, 1.5 inches. That the front end tilt will actually go into. And then, the rest of that will get cut off. Any excess will get cut off there. So the whole structure will all be tied together pretty much from the hood all the way to the rear apron will all be tied together. So this should be a very, very strong, good roll cage. The good thing about me having to redesign the cage, it kind of sucked, but the last cage was mild steel, and it was way thicker than what this DOM is, so the cage was way heavier. The shipping weight on all of this cage stuff, I believe was about 148 pounds or something like that. So when it's all said and done, the roll cage is probably going to weigh close to 250 pounds. Maybe 275 with this actual chassis, because the chassis part doesn't weigh anything. So, all of this is going to be extremely light. I could have went lighter and went with chromoly, but I don't have access to a TIG welder at the moment. So, and I haven't quite learned how to TIG weld quite yet. We just got one at work that we're going to buy this stuff to do all the TIG stuff with. So I'll start learning on that. Maybe some other projects in the future will TIG weld, but for now this is going to get MIG welded. Starting to look pretty good already. So after I get these all tacked in, good to go, get the chassis tacked to the actual cage piece, we'll slide it back under the car and get a height on the main hoop, cut that down, and then I can tack that in and just keep moving forward from that. This is kind of the basic design that I came up with. It should be quite functional. I may add bars, I may take bars out, I'm not 100% sure yet, but this is pretty much what it's gonna look like when it's done. There's obviously a couple pieces missing on the back. I never really got that far. I got too busy with work and stuff like that, but this is the basic design of it. Suspension will come off of this bar, and this lower bar here, and then the coilovers will actually bolt into this bar. Kind of same thing in the rear. I'll have more bars coming off this way that the suspension will actually bolt into. So this is kind of a reference. We'll see how everything looks as I'm starting to put it together, but I think this will work. I think it'll be awfully strong. So let's keep moving on the cage. What I've done here is fully welded this one, fully welded this one, and then put a couple stitches in there. Hold it all in. Once I get these two bars in here across, I'll no longer be able to slide the chassis back and forth on the actual rails. So I had to fully weld those. That way I could still get to them without having to cut stuff out of here and out of here. So welded those ones up. Go ahead and get the seat rails in real quick. I'm just gonna tack those in for now. And then we'll slide the chassis back underneath the bug. Still have quite a bit of stuff to clean up under here, but I got that one welded back in, got that one welded back in, and then the corners. So I'll grind all that stuff smooth. Went ahead and welded the underside of the bars on. So all that's looking good. Now we can slide this back under the chassis and start measuring for the main hoop. Get that in and be looking pretty darn good. Got the chassis back under the bug. Got it positioned right where it needs to be so everything lines up. Still have to pull out the old main hoop, but looking pretty good. Once I get the main hoop in, and probably the front bars and stuff like that, then I will start filling all this stuff in, get all that stuff. My square tubing, I still haven't heard back from them yet. So square tube will go in here, and then all of this stuff will get patched in as well on both sides. So let's get this old main hoop out and start fitting in the new one. All right, so after many, I think I tried notching it about 6 different times. But like everybody always says, you know, you can't really put metal back. You can weld it, but not so much in a roll cage. So I got this to fit exactly where I wanted it to be. So got them notched, got them cleaned up. They are lipped, so then the weld will penetrate all the way to the base. Let's get this in the car. Got the main hoop tacked in. Turned out absolutely perfect. I mean, it's really, really tight. Everything looks really good. If you look at it from the front, everything looks symmetrical. So it is extremely tight. I have maybe 1/8 of an inch between the roof and the actual cage. The last cage that I had in there was, I had like a probably 1.5-2 inch gap. So this would be nice, a lot more headroom. The halo bar will actually sit up higher as well. And then the A-pillar bars, when they come down, they're actually going to go into the dash and then down into the bar. So those will be tucked further forward. So all in all, this cage is turning out to be a real space saver. You know, the bug is extremely tight to begin with. It is, if you guys are new to the channel or haven't heard yet, this bug is channeled 3.5 inches. So there's 3.5 inches out of the body. And it's also got the 1 inch pan drop too. So in total, there's 4.5 inches out of this car. So with the cage being as tight as it can be, it definitely helps quite a bit. As you can see, the seat mounts are on the floor pretty much. So seats sit low, all of that. So we are looking pretty good. We'll start getting in the halo and start modifying the rest of the dash here for the A-pillar bars. And then we'll keep moving forward on the cage, getting all the front stuff done, getting the suspension on, stuff like that. So we'll keep pushing.
All right, guys, so that's all I have for you this week. Next week, we will be continuing on the cage, getting all that all set up and good. The Ghia video should be out maybe next weekend, if not midweek. Running into a couple cooling issues, but I think I have an idea. It just got too late today to diagnose that and try and figure that out. So I will update you guys on the Ghia. Hopefully this will be the last video of the Ghia. It'll be kind of a farewell, see you later video. So we will continue on both of them, and we will see you guys on the next one. Peace out, guys.